Hospital. so I knew my heart was fine. And my brain was fine, everything was fine. So it was something I had to figure out for myself. I think it may be my mum who sort of put the idea in my head and planted the seed that it was anxiety. I remember her looking up online anxiety and like the feelings that anxiety can give you and what symptoms it can give you, and they were all the same, and it was like this sudden like, oh my god, I'm not ill. And I was just, obviously I was ill mentally but not physically, so it was a big relief that it was something treatable. And then, so I'm just trying to think what we did next. Yeah, so after that I was sort of trying every avenue to improve my anxiety and to make it better and to try and improve it. And yeah, I would literally said, yeah, just help me, please. place. And so I started going to see her twice a week when I was really bad. And this lady, let me tell you, helped me immensely. So I was having Reiki twice a week. I didn't really know what it was at first. I just let her do her thing, and I knew that I was feeling the benefits. I knew that things were becoming more positive for me. She was giving me the tools to deal with my anxiety, and I think that's the main thing. I think once you've experienced anxiety, it never fully goes away. I would never ever say to someone I'm fully cured of anxiety, because you can very easily get triggered. It's just something that can come back, but it's something that you learn how to cope with, and you learn the coping mechanisms for it. So Carmen taught me how to cope when I am feeling anxious, what to do, and what to think of. She taught me how to gain back control of my mind, because I know that when you're going through anxiety, it feels like you're not in control of your mind, and it feels like your mind is in control of you. And she taught me that it is only me who's in control of my mind, and the only thing that controls my mind is me, and that I can take the reins of my mind and steer it any which way I want, and I can take the reins and stop myself thinking about worrying thoughts, and I can stop myself being anxious. And once I knew that, once I knew that I could change this and I did have control, it gave me all my power back. It was just like I knew that there was hope. And yeah, I'm getting emotional because it was very, very hard time in my life, and but I would never ever take it back. I would never take that time back in my life, because it has taught me so many valuable lessons, and it has taught me so much about myself and made me a stronger person. And I honestly think that it was meant to happen, because one. You're not the only one that this happens to. And I hope that by sharing my story, maybe you guys can share your stories with me as well, and maybe we can have discussions. Show you my techniques of what I do. I rarely ever have panic attacks anymore. Like, I went from going to having, I think I had, I'm gonna say about 6 or 7 panic attacks per day, to 0 per day, maybe 1 per month, probably not even that. One every 3 months, I would say. One every 3 months. So that's like 7 per day. Do one every few months, or not even. I mean, in the last year, I can only think of like 3 panic attacks. And so I just want to say